Let's take a look how easily you can add clickable hyperlinks to PDF generated from FileMaker with no plugins, just using calculations that work in FileMaker Pro, FileMaker Go, WebDirect, and server-side scripts. In this example, I have a list of links consisting of a title and the target URL. By clicking this button, I can export the list as a PDF. Now, when I open the PDF, as you can see, the links got exported as titled in underlined text, and each of them works as a link which I can click, and that takes me to the corresponding web page in a web browser. So let me show you how you can add this functionality also to your own custom app. This file is a fresh new database I created from scratch, where I just added this blue rectangle and a piece of text. So let me save it as a PDF. And now when I open the PDF in preview, you can see there is the blue rectangle and the text, but no link. Now, in order to be able to add links to the PDF programmatically, I just have to copy the three custom functions in this example. So I copy these three custom functions and I go back to the new file and paste them there. Now I have all I need to be able to add links to PDFs. To demonstrate that, I will create two container fields, one to hold the original PDF and one to hold the PDF with the link. If you examine the example in detail, you will notice that you don't have to use fields for this to work. But because it's more obvious with fields, I decided to use fields in this video. Now let me drag the fields to the layout. And here, this is the coordinates where I will want the link to be placed. Now I only have to add a script that will actually add the link to the PDF. I will select the second container as a target. And now I just have to define the calculation. I'll start with the PDF from JSON function, which actually recomposes PDF from the decomposed version that my custom functions work with. I have to give it a proper file name. Now I can add the PDF add link function, which does all the magic. And the PDF to JSON function will actually decompose the original PDF so that the other custom function can work with it. Now let me just set up the parameters, the URL I want the link to lead to, and the coordinates of the link on the page, which I take from the layout. You will normally do this dynamically in your script, but in this example, I am just hard coding it in the script. So let me save the script and try it out in browse mode. I will take the original PDF and drag it to the first field. Now I will run the script and that will create a new PDF with the link added. So I'll export the PDF back to the Finder and open it in preview. As you can see, the rectangle now works as a link that takes me to the page I defined in the calculation. Do you like it? So don't hesitate and download the example and try it out. And don't forget to share the results with the community.